I've made a copy of ODB20 query where, and I'm calling this one ODB21 query where part 2. After reviewing my last video, I realized that I missed a few things that we need to know before we can go on. Let's start with a quick review of what we already know and then move on from there. We're going into queries and going to create a query in design view. Let's add our table. And we want this query to select all the employees whose last names start with A or B. So I'm going to add in last name, first name, and I'm double clicking on the names, and we're going to put in another last name. We want this first last name's search criteria to say greater than the letter A, and I'm using a lowercase a. When I tab off this, we'll notice that it puts single quotes around our A. Let's also make our other last name less than the letter C, and I'm using a lowercase c. When I tab off this, it adds the single quotes as well. Let's also sort this in ascending order by last name, and I'm going to uncheck the second last name visible checkbox. Let's run this. And there we have our three last names that start with A or B, Adams, Anderson, and Brown. Now we used lowercase. What happens if we change this to uppercase? And I'm changing them inside those single quotes. Let's rerun this. And nothing changes. So whether it's lowercase or uppercase does not matter. I'm saying greater than A, but if I change this name to Adams, now it's saying greater than Adams. I'm clicking off there to make sure it locks in. We see that we no longer have Adams in there because Adams is not greater than Adams. Let's look at this in SQL view. It's in that single line. I'm going to reformat this to make it easier to read. Now it's all clear to us in our where clause that we have our field value in double quotes, then our less than or greater than sign, and our value in single quotes. That's where we left off in the last video. Let's go back over to design view. I'm going to delete off this second last name and remove our search criteria for name. And let's add in the hourly wage. I'm going to add a search criteria for that. I'm going to make this greater than 25 and tab over. And the first thing we notice is LibreOffice did not place single quotes around our 25. Let's add another hourly wage. This time I'll make this less than 30. And again, we do not see the single quotes around the 30. I'm going to uncheck the visible for our second hourly wage, and I'm going to sort by hourly wage ascending. I'm going to remove this sort, not sorted. Let's run this. And there we see 2570 is our lowest and 2919 is our highest. If we want to do the same thing we did last time with Adams, we'll make this 2570. And Helen Martinez should not show up in our next search. So that's how we do decimals and numbers. We do not put quotes around the number sign. What happens if we do put in a quote? Let's try it. I'll put single quote, 2570, single quote, tab over, and we already get a warning. The entered criterion cannot be compared with this field. I'll click OK, but I'm going to run this anyway. So what LibreOffice does in design view it says, I can't handle this computation. We're just going to take it off. So it took off our greater than 2570. I'm going to add that back in. Greater than 2570. Tab. I'm going to press F5 and rerun this. And there we go. We have our results again without Helen Martinez. Let's go over to SQL view. We've got our single line. I'm going to reformat this. Actually, why don't I reformat this and show you what I'm doing? I'm clicking over to before the first double quote. I'll hit enter, tab, space, space. Then I come over before the first comma, enter, tab, come over to the comma again, enter, tab. Now in front of the from, enter, enter. I want a little extra space there. Before the first double quote, enter, tab, space, space, so that they all line up. Before the where, enter, enter. Now before our hourly wage, enter, tab, space, space. Before our and, enter, space, space. To the order by, enter, enter. And before our last double quote, enter, tab, space, space. So that's what I'm doing when I'm lining things up. Now that it's all lined up, we can see that we don't use single quotes on our numbers in SQL view, just as we don't in design view. But what happens if we do add single quotes? I'm going to add them right before our 2570, just like we did in our design view test. Come up and click on the run query. And it looks like it works. Let's change this back to 25. Rerun the query. And there's Helen Martinez at 2570. So single quotes do work with numbers in SQL view. But we should probably be consistent where we can. So I am going to leave off the single quotes when I'm using number values in either design view or SQL view. Let's save this query. I'll save this as ODB21 query hourly wage. Let's go back into design view. I'm going to take off our hourly wage. And we haven't worked with dates yet, so let's add in a date. I'll pick the start date. Tabbing off. Let's run this query and see what we have. We see we've got all our dates. Now we want to narrow this down. So let's make our search criterion. We're going to look for employees that started in the 1990s. We want our start date to be greater than 1989-12-31. When I hit tab, it reformatted this into the format that it wants, which is 12-31-1989. Let's add another start date. Let's put in the start date. And we're going to make this less than 01-01-2000. When I hit tab, the value entered is not a valid date. Please enter a date in a valid format, for example, mm/dd/yy. So if I change these dashes to slashes. Now when I tab over, we see that it puts the hashtags around the date, just like it did our first start date. Let's uncheck the visible for our second start date, and I'm going to sort this by start date. Let's run it. looking at the data shows us that after adding in our sort, I did not lock that in. Let's rerun it. Now it looks a little better. Let's go over and see what this looks like in SQL view. I'll reformat this SQL to make it easier to read. Looking at our dates in SQL view, we see that there's a big difference between design view. Not only have our identifiers changed, but the date format has changed. So instead of hashtags, we've got these curly braces, then we've got a D, then in single quotes, we've got our date in year, month, day format, instead of the month, day, year format and hashtags in design view. I'm going to save this query as file, save as, and instead of hourly wage, we'll call this start date. So I've saved the query, and I'll save the database.